Hi folks, in this episode of Gourmet On The Road, we're going to taste some spicy, tasty Andhra fare. So stay tuned till the very end to savor what's for lunch at a culinary institution here in Nama, Bengaluru.
Some of that pappu, mix it well into that rice with that ghee and taste some of that vegetable with this. I love the juiciness of this chicken.
Hi folks, we are on Church Street in the heart of Bengaluru CBD. In the 80s and 90s, this was probably the most happening street in Bengaluru. This is where Bengaluru would converge. This was the hub of nightlife, entertainment and food. The pace of the street slowed down over the last few years to make room for development, to make room for infrastructure. But Church Street today is seeing a revival, a resurgence of sorts. And I'm here to lunch at an establishment that's been around for the last 20 years. It's been a while since I've tasted the Andhra style meal. So needless to say, I'm looking forward to my lunch here at BHEEMA'S. So let's go in and taste some tasty Andhra style delicacies. Let's go. We're here before the restaurant's opening hours, so of course there are no customers in here yet. But I'm sure by the time we leave, there's going to be a deluge of customers here. You know, when I walk in here, it's exactly like I walked into this place 20 years ago. And I think that's a wonderful thing because every once in a while, you're craving for a slice of comfort from the past.
Yeah. Hi, Kripal.
Hi, Vijay. How are you?
Doing good. How are you?
I'm doing well. So I'm here with Mr. Vijaykumar, who along with his father and brothers set up BHEEMA'S.
Exactly. BHEEMA'S. Actually, my dad wanted to start off because he was owning this building. He said, let's start off in the business. What? We went to construction.
All right.
So someone to advise him, why don't you start off on Andhra style?
Andhra style. All right.
And that's how the thing.
That's how it began.
Started. Yes.
It's been 20 years since then.
Yeah, it's been 20.
All right. And what are the dishes that people still come here for?
Yeah, your chili chicken, your roast. We have our special chicken BHEEMA'S.
All right.
They love our thalis too.
The unlimited thalis.
Yes, unlimited.
Right. And I think that also has a bearing on the name BHEEMA'S, right?
Yes.
So you're really expecting people to come here and eat their heart out.
Exactly.
Right. And perhaps is that why the restaurant is named BHEEMA'S?
BHEEMA'S, yes.
Yes, lovely. So can we take a look at the kitchen
sure.
and see what's happening?
Please welcome. Come.
Let's go. So let's get into the kitchen here at BHEEMA'S and see how all those Andhra dishes, all those Andhra specialities are created here. So this is where all the food gets
exactly.
cooked.
This is a primary kitchen. We get all the food cooked. It starts at 5:30.
5:30 in the morning.
5:30.
So I can see your cooks cooking on the kadai. And
yes.
then you also have the rational.
Yes.
The combi oven.
Combi oven.
What was the reason? Why did you... What comes out of the combi oven?
One is the main thing is slow cooking.
Okay.
And fuel saving. Food was tastier.
So these are your spices
yeah,
here.
Yes, yes.
So Vijay, I see two sets of spices here. I see some spices here too. And I see some spices here too.
So only for vegetarian.
Okay.
And that's only for non-veg.
That's very thoughtful.
We buy the chili, the turmeric steaks and the dhania seeds. And we powder them right in the kitchen.
Oh, really? Right, so for example, this turmeric that you have here, so that's powdered here.
It's powdered here. It's like a flour mill.
It's like a flour mill.
Flour mill.
So all the spices that you do
yes.
are ground here?
Ground here, completely.
Alright, lovely. Because I can also see the banana leaves there. The meal here is on a banana leaf, that's the tradition. Right?
More environmental friendly thing.
No steel, there's no plastic, and I think that's what makes that connection between the food and the person who's consuming the food. I think the banana leaf is that medium, it's that beautiful medium that straddles it all. Lovely. I think we'll go back into the kitchen and take a look. Here, the cooking is happening. Traditional food is being prepared in a very modern style using these state-of-the-art combi ovens. So this is slow cooking.
Slow cooking.
So what's cooking in there?
Mutton pepper fry.
Mutton pepper fry. And this is being cooked at 190 degrees.
190 degrees.
Steaming 100%.
Yes.
And for 174 minutes.
Yes.
Wow.
So that mutton pepper is going to cook in this controlled conditions using the traditional recipes,
exactly.
Using ingredients, spices that are ground here, but in a oven that's as state of the art as this.
Slow cooking really makes the taste, the flavors to come out very nice.
The flavors are a lot deeper.
Yeah. Become more tender and nice.
Ah.
And the masalas are being taken very well into the meat.
So what's happening with the pineapple here?
Pineapple, we use it for the biryani.
In the biryani masala?
Yes.
So with the meat, the pineapple also goes. So how much pineapple do you put in that?
It's just about 100 grams.
For about a kilo of meat. Now, so that is a very traditional way of cooking the biryani.
Yes, yes.
And like you were saying, this biryani that you do, so the biryani, the Andhra biryani that we typically associate with?
Nellore.
Is a Nellore style of biryani. So there you go, some pineapple too that goes into the Nellore style biryani, the Andhra biryani.
This is the biryani, chicken biryani.
The chicken biryani.
Yes.
So of course the biryani here is more cooked in the
pulao style. This is a basic masala.
Okay.
It's just cooked right now.
Okay.
It will be cooked for at least 60-70%.
Okay.
And then your dum is done on the machine.
Oh, the dum is done on the machine. Yeah. So you ladle the rice on top.
Top.
So this is the rice with that biryani
powder.
And this is the chicken.
Chicken.
That's cooked with the masala and that's cooked 75%.
75%, yes.
And it's got, I can see cardamom, I can see some bay leaf, some coriander.
Coriander and the mint leaf.
Mint leaf. Oh, this looks rich and flavorful. So all that gravy from that masala. And the chicken. Oh, wow. So basically, I think what makes it flavorful is all that masala that rice is now going to be cooked in. It's going to be slow cooked in that rice. So you've got the rice at the bottom of this pan and then you've got that chicken masala with all that gravy on top. So what's going to happen is that when this cooks, all that masala, all that gravy will be absorbed by the rice, thereby making it full on in terms of flavors. The biryani is gone, it's going to cook for 40 minutes.
40 minutes.
At 200 degrees Celsius, 70% humidity. The cooking of the biryani here is as precise as that.
Yes.
So nothing can go wrong.
Nothing.
Wow. So even the white rice here at BHEEMA'S, and I'm sure there's copious amounts of white rice that gets consumed here. How much rice gets consumed here?
50, 60 kgs.
50, 60 kilos in a day.
White rice.
So that rice too is made under controlled conditions in this coffee oven. So the rice, this is the rice for lunch today?
Yes.
I can see that Andhra chilli chicken.
This
is probably one of the most popular dishes here.
Yes.
You can see that chilli dancing with the chicken in that broth. So when it comes to Andhra food in Bengaluru, I think it's full on spice, right?
Spice.
It's full on, it's like a celebration of spice. It's the hotter the better. Is that how it is?
You sweat.
So only if you sweat, you enjoy the meal. Then the Andhra meal is good.
Yeah.
And I think that's how we like our Andhra meal here in Bengaluru. We like it spicy, we like it hot, we like it tasty, we like it flavorsome, we like it damdar, we like it masaledar. That's how we like our Andhra food here. And that chilli chicken that I'm watching being cooked here is just an example of what Bengaluru expects of Andhra food in Namakuru. Let's take a look at the mutton biryani. I think that combi oven also traps all that
all the steam and
so all the aromas.
Aromas are sticking.
I love the aromas that's wafting from that tray of biryani that's just been removed from that combi oven. So what makes this special? Is it
we have our own powders which we make it ourselves.
The blend of spices.
Yes. Yes.
So this is that special
biryani
powder. I can certainly smell the nutmeg. There's some nutmeg that's in it.
Mace.
There's a heat of the pepper.
Pepper.
So this is the secret sauce or the secret powder that is mixed in house and goes into the biryani and makes it unique.
Yes.
So these recipes controlled.
Control. The secret.
That's the secret.
The mutton jeera biryani.
Oh, this is a mutton jeera biryani. So this is the biryani that you said is more local style.
Local style. Yeah.
So is this similar because the color here is very similar to the Donne style biryani.
Yeah, it's almost same.
So that was the inspiration.
Yes.
And this is the biryani that's done in the jeera sambar.
Jeera sambar.
Also, this is like really short grain.
It's not soaked.
It's not soaked.
It is just washed two or 2 to 3 times, depending on.
So the basmati soap, this is not
soap? This is not soap.
And why is that?
Because it absorbs faster.
Ah,
you just only wash.
So if I look at the rice, it's as tiny as that. You know, I can smell the freshness of the herbs that have gone into this.
Yeah, we grow some, I mean, herbs on top, like our kothmiri.
Do you?
Coriander leaf.
Oh, so the coriander that's gone into this has been grown on top?
Yeah, the pudina and the curry leaves.
Oh, lovely.
We grow on top.
I think we're going to go.
Sure, I can show you my garden on top.
Yeah? So what is this? This is the...
This is a drumstick.
A drumstick.
Yeah, drumsticks are here.
But this is gone now or it's coming
it's
up?
It's coming up.
There's some coriander here as well. Ah, there's some beans that's right there. Mint here. Some curry leaves. You can taste the pungency of that curry leaf, the strength of that curry leaf. When I set out for Bhima this morning, I wasn't expecting to find a terrace garden growing vegetables and some fruits too. I found this ice apple here on top of a restaurant on the busy Church Street, but that's what I found. So needless to say, all this has got my appetite going and I can't wait to get to the table and taste some delicious Andhra style food here at BHEEMA'S. You know, this menu hasn't changed a bit. I don't remember the last time I came here, perhaps a decade ago. The menu was just the same. In this folded banana leaf, which is the banana leaf that you have on the table, and the menu resembles just that. There is a bit of the North Indian influence that I see, and also a bit of the Chinese influence in the Manchurian. But by and large, this menu is all about the Andhra specialities, and that's what we're going to try here. The banana leaf is wiped clean, but nothing like getting some water on your palms and sprinkling it over the banana leaf just to ready it for the meal that will follow. One veg meal we will do. Then we will do one chilli chicken. Then we will do one chicken bhima's. We'll do a mutton pepper fry. And we will do a mutton biryani. Nice and crisp, always a good sign. It's the small things that you taste in a restaurant that matter. Because if they pay attention to the small things, then you know the other things are definitely going to be taken care of. So I've got all my dishes for my lunch here. And of course I have my vegetarian meal, which is occupying center stage here. I have the rice, I have the pappu, that delicious Andhra style dal or lentil preparation. Then I have a vegetable, a beetroot, and I think there's some chickpeas in this. We have the mulangi chutney. And then of course the other accompaniments to the veg meals here. This is the sambar, the rasam, some curd or perugu as they call it, some paisam, this one is made with rava, some buttermilk. So that's the vegetarian part of our meal. And then we have the chicken bhima's, which I'm told is extremely popular. I haven't tasted this yet, but I'm looking forward to tasting this. This is a popular dish. I'm tasting this on popular recommendation. And then of course that super popular, very special chili chicken out here. The Andhra style chili chicken. You can see all those chilies there floating in that gravy, in that sauce. And then we have the mutton pepper fry. And last but not the least, we have the biryani here. That Andhra style, that Nellore style biryani that they cook here at BHEEMA'S. And we're going to make a beginning with the veg meals. To make a beginning with the veg meals, I'm going to first get some of this gunpowder, or what they call papula podi in Telugu. I'm going to get a bit of that on my hot rice, and I'm going to get some of that ghee or that nei. Get it all over that papula podi and rice. And make for a nice mound with that papula podi, that nei, the ghee and that rice. This is the only way to begin an Andhra meal. That powder,
It's spicy, it's nutty. You can taste the earthy texture of the lentils, the powdered lentils, and then the butteriness of that ghee as it envelops both the papula podi and that rice. This certainly gets your appetite going. Next, I'm going to go for that pappu. This is a spinach pappu today here. Go for the spinach pappu and that rice. What I'm also going to do is get some of that gongura chutney. The chutney is spicy, salty, and also quite tart. Get that rice and that pappu. That's a deliciously creamy pappu here.
Dal, sir?
Yes, it's quite nice. Thank you. Some hot steaming dal. Thank you. I think I'm going to also get some ghee on the rest of the rice. Lovely. Ah, thank you. Thank you. There's no such thing as too much ghee. I think the pappu has to rate as one of my favorite lentil preparations. I love the creaminess of that dal and the tomatoes and some of the greens that go into it, the spinach. It also makes for a nourishing lentil dish. That ghee takes that pappu in a whole new direction. Let's taste some of the beetroot and the chana, the chickpea actually. Not a big fan of the beetroot at all, but this makes for a tasty preparation. I think I'm going to get some of that pappu, mix it well into that rice with that ghee and taste some of that vegetable with this. There was a mulangi chutney here on my banana leaf. Not a big fan of that. I like the gongura a lot better. I think the gongura certainly has a more vivacious bite. When you have the gongura, you don't need any pickle. It's got the sa, it's got the heat and that deep spicy notes that go so well when mixed with some rice and some pappu. I'm going to now taste some of my non-vegetarian sides, and I'm going to make a beginning with the Bheema chicken. So this is a fried chicken preparation. I can see some liberal use of chilies here. I think some green chili that's been coated in this batter and deep fried along with the chicken, and of course plenty of curry leaves. We love our curry leaves in this part of the country. The chicken is crunchy, dry on the outside, but moist and juicy inside. I can also taste some of that star anise that's probably gone into that spice mix that this chicken has been marinated in before being deep fried. I'm going to get one of these chilies now, which is coated in the masala and then deep fried. It certainly has a bit of that chili heat still there. But this chicken is cooked perfectly. You got that nice crunchy batter, and then you got the moist meat inside. You can see some chili in there too. Get a complete bite of that chicken with the chili, the curry leaf, and all that masala. The curry leaf lends a unique, toasty, herbaceous note to that chicken, and then you taste the heat of that chili too. I think our meal here, our Andhra meal here, is just beginning to warm up. This is perhaps a good time to also taste some of that chili chicken, the Andhra style chili chicken, and that sauce. That sauce has an incredible amount of chili seed that's floating in it. So I'm going to go for the first bite without any of the chilies clinging onto my chili chicken here. The meat appears to be moist and juicy within. That's such a delicious bite. I love the juiciness of this chicken. Although you see much of the chili floating in this dish, floating in that gravy, Strangely enough, you don't taste the chili first. All that you taste is the juiciness of the chicken and the spicing. But as you eat the chicken, all the spicy juices that the chicken has absorbed whilst it's being cooked now begins to make its presence felt on your palate. So slowly but surely, you can sense the heat creep up on your tongue. I'm sure if you taste this chili chicken with the chilies, I'm sure it'll make for a numbing bite. I'm not going to do it right now because I still have some more dishes to taste. What I'm going to do next is go for the mutton pepper fry. This mutton has been slow cooked, has been braised slowly for over a couple of hours. And you can definitely feel that as the mutton peels away gently from the bone. You also have that fat, and that fat is rendered down into that meat. That's evidence of the slow cooking that we saw happen in the kitchen here at BHEEMA'S. You know, that meat is tender. You can see the tender pink flesh of this mutton that's been cooked so beautifully. All that you taste is the flavor of the meat and the pepper. What I like here is that the pepper doesn't overpower the meat. The pepper, though dominant in this dish, it's obviously a mutton pepper fry, doesn't obliterate the flavor of the meat. And that curry leaf provides for a nice respite in between tasting the meat. I think I'm going to call for some more rice and taste some of these meats with the rice and pappu too.
A little ghee?
Yeah. A little ghee, of course. Where would a self-respecting Andhra meal be without some ghee? Lovely. Some more ghee here too. Thank you. I'm going to go back for that pappu. And this time around, I'm also going to taste some of that BHEEMA'S chicken with that pappu. The ghee, the pappu, and some of that chicken. Time to do the same with that chili chicken. This chicken is cooked just perfectly. The fat in the ghee tames the aggression of the chili chicken quite beautifully. You're still tasting the heat of the chili, but in a more subtle fashion. I think I can probably risk going for some of the chili in this bite. That chili refuses to be tamed. If you have a low threshold for spice, do try the chili chicken, but avoid the chilies. But if you enjoy your spice and you're a chili champion, go for all the chilies in this chicken. It's as tasty as that. And time to go for some hot sambar. I'm going to divide my rice into two mounds and ladle that sambar. This is a radish sambar today. The sambar is nice and hot. For some chili, some tomato. So nothing as comforting as hot food. When the food feels hot to your fingers, your palate goes into overdrive, waiting for that food to be placed in your mouth. That's a tasty sambar. I think I'm going to go for some of that mutton pepper fry with that sambar. This piece of meat is soft. With the rice, the sambar, the mutton, and a curry leaf that snuck onto this bite. Try to taste some of this rasam. You typically eat the rasam at the end of your meal, and I've saved some rasam for that to be drunk after that biryani. But I just want to taste some of that rasam with this rice. Rasam, rice, and some papad. The perfect combination. A bit of a gongura as well. The sour spinach. That gongura has the ability to perk up the simplest of foods. With its vivacious, sour and spicy personality. Thank you. time to go for the biryani here. The biryani is very subtle in its aromas. We were watching that biryani being cooked in the kitchen, where you had the rice at the bottom and then you had the masala along with the meat that was ladled on top. This rice has absorbed all that masala. You can taste that masala in every strand of the rice that has been stained by the spices that went into the masala. So I can taste the cloves, I can taste the cinnamon, I can taste the star anise. This meat is cooked to a tender pink. You know, what's interesting here is that when you're tasting the meat, you're more or less tasting just the flavor of the meat. You're not really tasting the spices or the masala, all the other things that have gone into making that meat masala. All that has found its way into the rice. The meat has lent the flavor of its masala, of its spicing to the rice, which makes the rice supremely flavorful. This is a gentle, mellow flavored slide of the bone. We'll mix the rice now with the meat and get a complete mouthful of this mutton biryani. The meat and the rice comes together so beautifully. The mild, meaty flavors of the meat and the rice that's brimming with all the spices that is absorbed as it was cooked. And if you like your biryani a little masaledar, get some of that chicken gravy and mix it into your biryani. It makes it moist and very masaledar. But if you ask me, if you want to savor the true character of this Nellore style biryani, eat the biryani, just the rice and the meat, to appreciate the delicate nuances of this biryani. I think I need some of that rasam as I come to the close of this very indulgent meal here at BHEEMA'S. Just to help digest things in my stomach, we have some curd here. Traditionally, of course, I would end the meal here with some curd rice, with some perugu annam. Perugu meaning curd, annam is rice. But I've eaten so much rice that I don't really have space for any more rice. So I'm just going to savor this thick perugu or curd just by itself. Some rava paisam or semolina paisam to close my meal here. Some banana that's gone into it. I think if you're looking to savor a great Andhra meal, definitely check out BHEEMA'S here in Namma, Bengaluru. I think what's interesting is the way they've held on to their traditions, the way they've held on to their culinary practices, yet making room for the modern to enhance the flavor of what's on offer. And I think that's what makes a meal at BHEEMA'S truly satisfying. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating.
At Food Lovers TV, my team and I work hard to produce engaging food and travel videos. If you like our work, do check out our Patreon page, where you can pledge a nominal sum in lieu of special privileges like behind the scenes footage, early video release, exclusive Q&As, merch and much more. For more info, check out the link in the description below. Also, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to subscribe, share, like and leave a comment here. Happy eating!